Hi guys, this is Yunmin. In the previous video, we learned about the ID and class attributes in HTML. Actually, those concepts are very related to DOM. As I brought it up before, the ID and class attributes are used to manipulate a DOM element. Also, DOM allows JavaScript to make the HTML page active. So the DOM is an important concept for web developers. In this video, we're gonna look at the DOM in general. I'll explain what the DOM is and what you can do with the DOM. Okay, let's get started. DOM is an interface to access HTML documents. It defines all elements in a document and the way a document is accessed and manipulated. Let's talk a little bit about what the DOM actually is. DOM stands for Document Object Model, and it's an API for manipulating HTML documents. You can imagine the DOM as a tree of nodes or elements created by the browsers. The DOM represents an HTML document as a hierarchy of nodes. The following tree represents the above HTML document. As the term implies, DOM is an object-oriented model, meaning that each object has its own properties and methods that we can access. It would be better to understand each term in DOM one by one. Document is a file that has its extension ends with .html. Object is an element. Any tag in your document is an object. Head tag is an object. Body tag is also an object. Let's see what model means. It basically describes how these objects lay down in a document. Model is some kind of hierarchy tree. Then what can we do with the DOM? JavaScript can change HTML element contents such as attributes and styles. The HTML DOM is a standard for how to get, change, add, or delete HTML elements. The HTML DOM can be accessed with JavaScript. As I mentioned above, the DOM represents a document with a logical tree. Here's an important part. DOM methods allow programmatic access to the tree. We're gonna touch on the DOM methods shortly. With them, one can change the structure, style, or content of a document. DOM provides the properties and methods of each object. A property is a value that you can get or set, and a method is an action you do. There are lots of properties and methods that handle each object, but especially today I'll introduce you two methods that are used to select elements. The first one is getElementById. It's a quick way to access an element because the ID of an element is unique within an HTML document. It returns a DOM element specified by an ID or NULL if no matching element is found. If multiple elements have the same ID, even though it's invalid, the method returns the first element it encounters. Let's suppose that we have this HTML document. Let's get an element that has an ID called greeting by using getElementById method. Write the ID name in parentheses like this. You can see the output like this. Secondly, let's cover getElementByClassName. We can use the getElementByClassName to select elements with class name. It returns an array-like object of the child element with a specified class name. It's available on the document element or any other elements. Let's see with examples. To look for the element with class dashes, you use this code. As we did in ID method, write the class name that you want to select. You don't have to know map and call methods right now. Instead, let's see how this method brings the element. This example calls the method on the document object. Therefore, it searches for the elements with the class dashes in the entire document. So far, we've learned how to select a DOM element with the methods especially that can search and manipulate elements. After selecting an element, you can give style to the element and manipulate its attributes. Alright, today we learned about DOM. In order to fully understand, it would be nice to explore more about how DOM works and to practice applying these things to your web page. Hope you guys make an awesome web page. Thanks for watching. Bye!